Yeah, I block Canada. I don't really want to make this video, but I feel like I'm forced to make this video. Because yes, I block Canada and it's just between him and me. But lately, I have got so many messages from the pinball community, from content creators, from people on his page and my page, that we all know each other, and they're in shock what's going on, because Kaneda and I was a great team, great friendship. And I'm not talking about pinball friendship only. This guy could call me when I was working out. I was demotivated, I couldn't lift anymore. I had my AirPods on and my phone called, and where's my phone? And I just answered. I didn't know who it was. And I picked the phone and I said, hello. And this voice from New York says, like, there's no easy way out. Da-na. There's no shortcut. No. Oh my God. Chris takes me back to 1987. I'm watching Rocky again, motivates me, and sending workout pictures to each other and talking about family, what's going on. Such a good friend. And it's not every day in your 40s you find a friend, a great friend that you sync so much with. I mean, we're about the same age. We grew up in the Neo Geo, in the arcades era. So we have so much in common. And Canada is one person. But Chris, you don't know Chris. You don't know Chris. Chris is not Canada. Because when we talk on cam, it doesn't matter where your friends are located. 5 kilometers, 1500 kilometers from you, it doesn't matter. You're online, you're talking with each other. When the camera is on, when we start recording a show, this media trained, high polished, completely professional Kaneda comes on and he's just on, and nobody can compete with him. He's the best. I know. When we say recording is off, bam, Chris comes up. And Chris is full of empathy. I know you don't trust me now, you don't believe me now, but full of empathy. So warm, so lovely guy. His voice is different. He talks different. He's so sweet. When he calls me 1 o'clock at night, I'm like, hello. And he, if he says, and if he starts the conversations by saying, oh shit, then I know something. Then I know, okay, wake up, Jengis. He's gonna tell you something awesome now. And I have distro info, and some of the times when this guy tells me stuff, I'm in shock. It's NDA stuff that he knows about. It's so crazy. But it is what it is. I really liked Chris a lot. Okay, we talk daily. But now I blocked him. A guy that I really, really like, I blocked him. Yes. And to my big surprise, instead of it being in between him and I, he goes on his live shows and says that I'm a sensitive guy. That's why I blocked him. And he says that I get offended fast, me. And I blocked him because something Pedretti Gaming said. That's not the reason. Let me tell you what happened. So all you guys that are contacting me, so all you guys know what's going on. Because we were a great team. When we make videos, thousands of views, your guys' messages were like, Retro Django and Canada, my favorite duo, more videos, more. Okay. I wake up a couple of days ago, 6:44 in the morning. Okay, I want to make breakfast to my kid. Turn on my phone and I can see my buddy Kaneda is on live. All right, so I just click there, put my phone to the charger, and it's like 3 meters from me at the wall, hanging at the wall, charging up, and I'm making breakfast. Kaneda is just all over the place, and he's like, yeah, guys, I'm gonna delete this video. That's where I went in. He's gonna delete this video. And I was like, what happened? What happened? This is one of his rant videos. So I went closer and took a look at him, and he looked tired. Yeah. So there was something on the text and upcoming games, and there was somebody saying something like Twilight Zone. And I was like, oh, no. Took the phone, just dried my hands off, my wet hands. I was like, it's 6 a.m. for me, guys. And I wrote, no, Twilight Zone is not coming. Okay, it's not coming out. Because I made a video a couple of days ago telling about Pedretti Gaming told me about this. They're not making Twilight Zone. I said that, left the phone, started the breakfast again. Short later, Kaneda was like, oh, Cengiz, coming in late. And his show was on for an hour or something. I don't know. That was like 4 or 5 o'clock for me. Cengiz coming in late, coming in hot, talking about he knows shit. He knows nothing. Why should Pedretti Gaming or any company say any info for a guy in Denmark? Why should they share information with a guy from Denmark when the best pinball podcast guy is in New York, is in the United States? Chris, the world is much bigger than North America. The world is much bigger. And it doesn't matter if I'm in Denmark or in London or in India, wherever. If I speak English as good as my skills, I'm not the best, I know. No matter where in the world I upload a pinball video about pinball news, it will pop up everywhere on YouTube. So undermining me like that multiple times, why should any company share anything with Retro Django? No, he says, thank God he says Cengiz, because not many people knows or uses my name. People on YouTube, on media, they call me Retro Django. So he says Cengiz, but he keeps on talking like this. And I'm like, why is he talking like this? I'm in shock, but he's talking. He is keeping on talking. And then he says, Cengiz, he knows nothing. 2 seconds later, he says, why don't he share his knowledge with us? So I know nothing, or do I know things I want to share? And I was like, okay, dried my hands off, took the phone. And he knows this for so long time. I have distro info, I have company info, and my best friend, my twin, my clone here in Denmark is a huge distro, okay? When I say to him, I give you my word, my dear brother, I give you my word, when you're on a Zoom call with Jersey Jack, include me, okay? We're bros, we're doing this together. So everything he knows, I know. He trusts me and I trust him. He tells me stuff. I'm a content creator. I don't share stuff that is not there to be shared yet. I know it. I know what's going on. It helps me. I love everything about it, but I have so much love and respect. So my word is sacred. Okay. So many times I have told Kaneda, no, I'm not going to share that info. When he calls me and he has some info that I'm shocked about, then I say, okay, that is true. But before that, no. So I write on that live show where so many people are live. We have an audience there. And I write there, well, Chris, I don't share the info because I gave them my word. Okay, my word is sacred. Chris looks at the phone camera. He says, I love you, brother, but fuck your word. Like, I was like, what? On a live stream? I love you, brother, but fuck you. Fuck you, fuck you. All the time. I love you, but fuck your word. Fuck you. He kept on just pissing all over me. Fuck you, fuck you. I love you, but fuck you. Fuck your word. Why don't you just tell? You are not even a... He says, Genghis, you are not even a distro. Just tell. Just tell everything. You're not... Fuck your word. It's like, okay, so fuck all my relationships with all the companies that makes pinball machines. And I'm friends with them on YouTube, and I talk with them, and I have inside information. So should I just fuck all that? I have close contact with distros all over the world. Can talk with them. How many of the games did you get? How many did you sell? How is this company treating you? How many illies, how many C's are we getting? So fuck all that distro contact info. And the most important part, my best friend for years, the guy that trusts me, fuck him and just tell everything. Fuck your word. Fuck your, I love you, Genghis, but fuck your word. It doesn't work like that. And I was totally in shock. I was like, what's going on? I just woke up. I was constantly thinking, because nobody talks to me like that. Should I take the plane first class to New York and break this guy's door in and say, what the fuck is wrong with you? I mean, what? So I was considering that, or drive my son to school. You see the dilemma. There were this guy in there that's called Dom. Dom's pinball show, something, a new guy. And Canada was like, oh, Dom, or Don, I think it's called. You got 3 Patreon guys. You're getting $15 a week, or what he's getting, or it's a month. I don't know. I have 600. I'm the biggest. You're so small. I will pay you $15 to shut down your Patreon. And this Don guy, he was like, I was like, what the? You can't speak like this. Okay, this Don guy, he can take it, but I can't. I'm not built like that. So I was like, okay, just cleaned my hands again, took my phone, and I wrote, I don't want to write fuck. Canada keeps on saying, I don't care. This show is going to be deleted. No one can see it. So in between lines, I can say what the fuck I want to say. I wrote to him, WTF. In a good way, WTF is wrong with you today. On that live show, his response were like, nothing is wrong with me. I love you, brother, but fuck your word. You're not even a distro. You're just a guy in Denmark. Who should share anything with you? Why should any company share anything with you? Undermining me like this. And it doesn't matter why should, who should, what. The only thing that matters is his fuck yous towards me. That's the only thing on a live show. This is public. People can go in. Nothing with subscribers. Everybody can go in and listen to this guy saying, fuck you, Genghis. Fuck your word. My word that is sacred. Okay? I unfriended him. Yes. I have so much personal info, but I will never share it. I will take to the grave with me because that's personal. That's with Chris and I, with family stuff. I will never talk about it, never behind his back. I can block him. I can ignore him, but never because of love and respect. I'm that way. Okay, I'm that guy. So after that, nothing is wrong with me. Blah, blah, blah. I'm in shock. To be honest, at that point, I was angry. Because I tried to write, you know, because I gave my word, okay, let's quit it. I can't. And what the fuck is wrong with you? And it got worse. Okay, all the fucks. And I don't want to say I'm a sensitive guy. I don't want to say I am easily offended. What the fuck? But I was like, okay, he's drunk. Because he was out on these drunken rants for some time ago. And after the last one he did, long time, a year ago or something like that, I called him the next day. I said, Chris, you're done with that. You have to swear to me that you will never drink and go live again. Never, ever. And I really mean that. And he said to me, bro, I promise you, I'm done with that. And you know what? He kept his promise. He stopped. From that day, it just stopped. Okay. So I feel like Chris is a great guy. He's a great friend to have. I'm not talking about pinball now. As a friend, he can listen. He can give you advice. He's fun. He's cool. He has got larger than life personality. I love stuff like that. Okay. If Chris and I went into a bar, everybody would know we're in there. Okay. It's hard to explain. I wish I just recorded one of our calls to each other. I love that guy. But I was like, this can't be true. So I wrote on his live show while he was fucking everything. I was like, Chris, have you been drinking? I mean, there's people listening to this, watching this. He can say whatever he wants to say. I can't defend myself. I can answer back. I can write a message, but the message were like glowing in there because everything was on fire and Chris was fucking and pissing everywhere. And I was so angry. I was so angry at that point. I wrote, have you been drinking? Are you drunk? Is that why you're doing this? He looked at the camera and he says, nah, man, I just had a beer. I'm not drunk. And then he imitates my bad language, bad English accent. Now Jenkins is going to call me and he's going to say, bro, you sound tired. Go in and sleep with, hug your wife and sleep with her. Drop this pinball life stuff. Drop all that. Go into your wife. Go in and get some sleep. Killian will be up early in the morning. Have some energy to that. Oh, Genghis will call me and give me some advices. I'm so tired about advices. If you knew how many advices. Talking like this. You know what, Chris? Friends that cares about each other, they want the best for each other. Yes, I do call you, I do give you advices. You won't get it because I understand now that you just don't get it. So stop this video, watch it together with your wife, watch it together with Brenda. Okay, she's so sweet. She will get this, she will get it, and she will explain it. She will tell you. It's only a good thing that I call you, that I say, drop this live show, drop. Chris can send me, he's making these great memes on his Facebook group. So some sort of picture, and at the top he writes something, at the bottom he writes something, and when I see them while at work, something, you know, I get this, all of a sudden, bam, I laugh, I crack up because he's so spot on, he's right on point, it's so funny. And I call him up, oh buddy, shattered on your page, it's so fun. But other times, he can send me these memes that he makes. When I get them, I'm like, oh shit. Call him right away, Chris, you can't share this. Don't share this, because yeah, that's between Chris and I. You can't share this, delete it. And he doesn't share it, okay? He doesn't share it. So friends are like that, okay? Friends are like that. I was down because I lost a great friend because of Canada. This friend I had for years, he unfriended me because of Canada. And I was real down because I really liked this friend. And Canada was out. He sent me pictures. He was out on a bar. He was having so much fun. And I wasn't just that keen. I was down. And he just felt it somehow. And he called me. And I told him this and this. And he stopped the party. Went out. He was talking to me. And he said, you know what? This, this, and that. Really, really helped me. Really helpful. Again, full of empathy. Such a nice guy. Chris is a nice guy, but he says, no, I just had a beer, you know, fuck you and your advices. I love you, brother, but again, just tell us. You don't know nothing, you know everything, but you don't want to tell it to us. It was so messed up. It was so messed up, and I was like, okay. I don't want to be a part of this. This is just friends. Real friends are not like this. They don't go out in public and just with no reason. I mean, if there was a reason, I understand. If I messed up, if I did, I understand. But no reason. Woke up, join my friend's life, support his show. Okay, that's it. Nothing else from me. I was fed up. And I just wrote on his show, goodbye, Chris. That's it. Because I could get angry. I could do a lot of stuff. I have a lot of temper in me. But because of the love and respect, nothing else. And I love this guy. I love his family. I love Killian. I know his dad before Killian was born, and now Killian is 2 years old. When I talk with Chris, when he calls me in the morning, Killian is at the phone. He takes the phone. Gaga talks to me. I love that baby. I blocked Chris, okay, because of the love and respect. I didn't. It will just be so bad if I gave him the fox back, okay? So just chill out. You're not 19 anymore. Chill out. Block him and ignore him. Went into his page, unfollowed, but I didn't block his page because, to be honest, sometimes he posts pictures with Killian, and if I block it, I can see. Yeah, I want to see him grow up. So, so I lost a great friend with no reason. Blocked him. Then I get an email like, yo, what's up, bro? I wanted to say something, but you blocked me. I don't know. I don't understand why. That's like the worst thing. That's the worst thing you can do. Just, oh, nothing. And another email like, is it just because we had some fun? Is just ignoring, you know? That made it even worse. And then, I don't want to mention names, but then I get contacted, you know, You all know... We have mutual friends on these live shows in the pinball industry. So there are some of them that were in there. They write to me, oh man, you took a lot of shit. I mean, it was really bad. I mean, whoa. And Carrie writes to me, Carrie Hardy, such a nice guy, great YouTuber. He writes to me, you know, what happened? Why did you block him? And I was like, okay, how did Carrie know? I mean, what's going on? So he went down, he reached out to Carrie and, you know, contact Genghis and I don't know what's going on. So I talked with Carrie about it and such a nice guy. A lot of non-media creators, but heavy guys in the pinball industry wrote to me, thank you guys. I mean, thank you for just reaching out. I don't want to say support. I don't want to talk like that, but just thank you for reaching out to me. And then all of a sudden, Zach Mini from Flipping Out and, you know, Straight Down the Middle Pinball Show, Zach reaches out to me and says, you know, what's going on? Why did you block him? And I'm like, I understand, you know, Carrie reached out because Carrie is on all the live shows. But Zach reaching out, I'm like, the first question just came to my mind was like, Zach, how do you know this? I mean, how? And he was like, well, he was poking you at a show and talking about you. I was like, this can't be true. This just can't be true. It was true. And I... thank you, Zach, for reaching out. And I was like, at that moment, some time has, a couple of days later, this is 2 or 3 days later or something, I wasn't angry anymore, but I was sad. I was sad because this is a guy that I talk with every day. Okay, every day he makes me laugh. We share some info. I really love him. Such a great friend. Okay. Now I lost him. I miss him. I miss Chris a lot. A lot. You don't get it. I miss him. I really love that guy, man. But, you know, talk with Zach. And I love Zach. I have nothing against him. And I'm so much down. While we're talking, I said to Zach, because, can I say this? I'm going to say this. I don't care. Zach warned me. Zach, he said, okay, Genghis, you're dead wrong here with this Chris guy. He will fuck it up for you. Just wait and see. Just wait and see. So Zach warned me and I ignored it. Fast forward to now. I was just sitting there and I said to Zach, before Zach said this to me, I said to him, Zach, I'm down. I'm sad. I don't want you to say to me, I told you so. Just don't say that right now, okay? I don't want to listen to stuff like that. And Zach said, no, nobody, I'm not going to say nothing like that. I just want to say, don't get sad because Chris does this. He is like this. He has done it before. Okay, he has done it before. He has done it to him. He has done it to other friends. He's like that. After that conversation with Zach, I felt much better because I was very confused. I was like, I didn't do nothing. Why did this happen? I didn't do nothing. So that's the first thing. And the other thing, I'm not the first one this happened to. This is something that just happens. So I can't be sad about it. Because this is just, we're different people. Okay, we're different people. For some, your word is sacred. For others, fuck your word. I want to spread as much news out as I can. I don't know. And then he goes on his shows, asks people to write to me. So I go to Messenger, and there were like so many, this guy wants to talk to you, and you get these notifications and like, oh, you have to go into Canada's show. He talks about you. He shows something. And I just go in and look for 1 hour mark. And I went in, and he make these pictures. So sweet. So sweet. I mean, he is a sweet guy. Okay. But he's still laughing. He's still saying, I just blocked him. Some people are saying to me, Retro Django, that's because he got envy of you. His envy, you have the info. That's why he says nobody will share nothing with a guy from Denmark when the world's number one pinball media content creator in US, Canada, they have to share it with him. That's how Canada is thinking. Again, it doesn't matter where in the world I am. And this one was with Pedretti. I mean, it's so close to me. Pedretti is down there to me. Pinball Brothers is just next to me. The world is bigger than the US, okay? I mean, so some says he was envy. I don't know. I don't get envy with my friends. He sent me numbers every day. I have so many Patreon subscribers, and I called them, congratulations, brother. It's so cool. Congratulations with your success. He got happy. I got happy. He got more subscribers. I got happy. He got bigger audience. I got happy. Why? Because we're friends. We're in this hobby together. So he talks, keeps on talking. It feels like he wants to say I'm sorry, but he's not man enough to say it in a straight way or something. He wants to laugh and say it and tell to the people that I'm a soft, sensitive guy that doesn't want to talk and just, I blocked you because I love you, because of the respect, man. I just don't get it. But hey, so many people has reached out to me. I want to say thank you to everybody. Jason Knapp sent me a friend request. I love Jason. I love what he's doing. So cool. And being called this little guy, if a guy like Jason Knapp knew that I was admin for 4 different Facebook groups, Danish, Scandinavian, international, not only pinball, but also arcade, but also Commodore 64, 8-bit games, Nintendo games. I make Amiga videos, retro PC videos on my YouTube channel, okay? And through that retro PC, Amiga, Nintendo console gaming community, I have with thousands of subscribers on my YouTube channel. Those guys from that kind of hobby watches at a pinball machine on my background and on or arcade games or something else. They're like, is it possible to have a pinball machine in your home? How did you? Where did you? And I share the info. I share my videos. So those people from retro computing, they start collecting pinball machines because of my videos. If a guy like Jason Knapp knew this, he will vote me for the best pinball ambassador for the year. I watched a live show while I was sleeping. Canada made like 2.5 hours live show where he was talking about me. It was his best live show like a month ago or something like that. So people opened their homes to him so he could share this game. And one of the games, he was one of the guys, he asked him, how, when did you come into pinball and stuff like that? And the guy's answer to Chris on Canada's live, he said, well, I saw you making a video with Retro Django. Then I learned about Canada, I learned about pinball, and now I have like 17 pinball machines in a year or something like that. And Chris was like, what? This little guy in Denmark can do that? Yes, the world is much bigger than the United States, okay? So all this being said, I have one message to Chris. Because Chris made these pictures to me on his last live show where he said that I was perfect and he loved me. And I love this guy. And none of you will understand this. Only Canada will. This one doesn't go out to Chris. I won't disrespect him like that. But this one, from my heart, as an answer, goes back to Canada. Fuck Canada. Okay, not Chris, but Canada. Okay, and none of you dad rockers will understand this. Just give it a minute. But Canada will understand it. We won't have no words. Here we go, Canada. About my bad haircut. Now it's all about Versace. You couple my style, 5 shots couldn't drop me. I took out a smile, now I'm here to set the record straight with my AK. Now you all know Canada's version, my version, and make your own what is the true version. So, no more messages for me. If you're in doubt, just take this one. No more messages, no more ideas, no more what's going on, nothing. I wanna go in and check out Killian. How he does. You won't get new videos with Chris and I because we're just different. I would never say to a friend, fuck you, in public, in his face, no matter how envy I was. I don't have no enviness in me. I don't have got that feeling. I would never talk like that. And if I fucked a friend over, I will go to him and I will suggest, smack me in the face a couple of times. I'm deeply so sorry. I was a jerk. I wouldn't just call him. I wouldn't just say, you're just sensitive. What the fuck's wrong with you? You're just sensitive like a little girl, a little girly man. What the fuck? Or sensitive is one thing, but easily offended? Offended? It's just the worst word you can use in 2023 because of Gen Z people. They're just off. I'm not that kind of guy. Just makes everything worse, man. My anger goes down and I'm just sad and just Oh, Genghis just offended like a little girl. What the? On top of all this? Just think about losing a great friend that you have so cool vibes with. Okay? Chris, he says we're like East and West. We're like Axel and Slash. We're like, you know, the guys from Predator. Oh man, it was so cool. What a friendship. I mean, in your 40s, it's not easy, okay? It's not easy. But before all of that, everybody has their own way of living, okay? My word is my word. I don't break it. I don't get offended. Not that easy. My reaction to this by blocking out was only from love and respect and nothing else. If it was someone else, I would just break his jaw. That's it. I won't go to a corner and say, I'm offended. I will not even say, fuck you back. Everybody's different. So this is why, guys, let's leave it at that. I have nothing more to say. I wish Brenda the best. I wish Killian grown up a fantastic kid. I mean, I love that kid. And from the bottom of my heart, and I really mean this. I wish the best for you, Chris. I really mean this. I hope you find a big house very soon. Have a lot of space for your kid. Make your own arcade room. Get many subscribers on Patreon. I just wish you will treat your friends good, because good friendship is priceless. Carrie Hardy, he writes to me, I'm a bit confused. Chris says, can you help me by getting Genghis's address? Because I want to order a Space Hunt pinball machine to him. And you know, Carrie Hardy writes, that must be an internal joke. I'm telling you guys, Chris and I are like that. As a joke, he could just order a pinball machine for me. I mean, you don't know half of how our talks and conversations was. And I just miss Chris a lot. And I'm so sad about this, man. And Chris he won't get this. He will, I'm sure he will first be angry. He won't understand this one. He will probably make fun of me. But Brenda will get this. And he will probably say, Chris, come on, man. And it is what it is. Everybody else, thank you for listening, for my rant for like 45 minutes. This is the first time ever I make a video like this. That's because my love and respect for a friend. And that's because after everything, this guy is still on live saying that I got offended like a little girl and I couldn't talk. He says something like, Genghis took his ball and went home. How the fuck can you talk like that about me, man? On top of that, I have to deal with losing a great friend. Yeah, I lose everything here. Not Chris, it's me. Everybody else, have a great day. Take good care of your friends. Call your friends up. Call your friends right now. Just tell them you love them, man. Just tell you appreciate the friendship. Buy some six-pack beers. Visit them. Is it Pinball Friends? Go visit them. Visit each other. Play some game together. Have a drink with your friend. Or is it American cars. I ride motorcycles. My motorcycles. Call your friends from school. Take them, motivate them to work out and train with you. Use some time with your friends, man. It's friendship is the best in the world. Don't fuck a friend over. It's so important. Numbers, fuck numbers. Patreon supporters, fuck Patreon supporters. Money, fuck money, man. It's family and friendship. And this guy is half Sicilian. This is coded into his DNA. I've got Sicilian friends here. I know how they are. Family and friendship, that all that matters and nothing else.